Hello and welcome to another stream. My name is Ray and it is Learning Korean with Ray, day 150. Yes, 150. Yeah, but we'll just continue as always. We go into a vocabulary review, which will be rather short, I guess. And then we will go and continue the grammar lesson about the passive verbs. We should come closer to the end, so then I don't think we'll reach it today, but maybe, and then we can take a look at the practice exercises, videos, whatever. But yeah, let's see. So first of all, before we start anything, we go for the vocabulary review. Okay, 31, more than I expected. Let's go. Heavy. Yeah. Heavy. Don't remember this one. What do we have here? Sin. Ton. Sin. Shim. Gop. Gop. One. Mu. Ah, Mu Gop. Mu Gop Da.
Mu Gop Da.
Yeah. That's it. Hyeonggeum. Kakkim. No, Kakkim is sometimes. Dongshie. I don't know this, man. Jigim. Bangim.
Bangim.
Pangim. Okay, that's it. Okay. Nukcha.
Nukcha.
Something shil. Shilmun. Shilmun, I think. Shilsu.
Shilsu.
Yeah. Because Mun is water and Su is also related to water. That's why I thought Shilmun, but it's Shilsu. Okay, to use Suda.
Suda.
Breath. Sum.
Sum.
Together, 같이.
같이.
To come in, 나오다. Oh, okay, 나오다 was to come out. 2 syllables and then oda. I have to look at the options. Ah, okay, there it is. 들어오다.
들어오다.
Foreign country. 외국.
외국.
Music. Music. There's a word called music, which the Koreans use sometimes. It's, well, from the English word, obviously. But there's also another one. I think Immak.
음악.
Every year. 매년.
매년.
Bread. 빵.
Bang.
Temperature. 온도. 온도.
온도.
온도. 이.
이.
오, garbage. 쓰레기 쓰레기 쓰레기
쓰레기
쓰레기. Hi Flo, thanks for tuning in, and also to the other person watching, thank you. Last night, Jinan... No, that's not correct. Ojetbam.
Ojetbam.
Famous. Famous. I know when I learned it. I want to say it has something with like a J or like ya, yo, you. I think I know. It's actually Yumyuda, something like that. Yumyuda? Something like that. I will look at the options, but it's close to that, I think. Ah, here we have Yumyongda. Yeah. Yumyonghada, okay.
Yumyonghada.
Yumyong. I said Yumyu, and it's Yumyong. Close enough, I would say. Sahua? No, wait. Jangbu. Bujang. Pujang Nim is boss. And so this one is Jangbu, I think. Weird. Let me check the options. Ryo? No. Ah, Jong and not Jang. Ah.
Jongbu.
Okay. To repair, Suri, Hada.
Suri.
Personality. Was this is Huek? Sangwek. No, I don't know anymore. Song. Oh, this one. Kyok. Song Kyok.
성격
성격 성격 okay 성격 to breathe 숨다 why not 숨다 숨하다 숨 is breath to do breath should be true 숨 There was this, it's only a da, it's not hada, and there's another syllable in the middle. I want to say something with S. Some suda? No, some. Some shwida?
Some shwida.
Nice. To be light, not heavy. Anmukup. Anmukup. Yeah. Gigan. Ah, this one is it. Gbyop. Gbyop da. G. Pyop. Pyop. Pyop g da. Ah. Ga. Whoops.
Gabiopta.
Okay. Not the cleanest Suda. Session. Suda. Beverage. Nyo. Su.
Nyo su.
These days. I know this one. I will remember it. Your chum, I think. Your chum. Your chum, chum. Your. Chum? Chum?
요즘.
Yeah, nice. To go in. Okay, we had in. Now I remembered. 들어가다.
들어가다.
들어가다. Jealous. She... 시작하다. No, she 시작하다 is to start. Jiltuhada. Yeah, Jiltuhada.
Jiltuhada.
Now that I thought about it, it's quite weird to have this letter in the middle of a word, of a verb, in my opinion. But yeah, Jiltuhada is still correct. Curtain. Probably was this one. Cotton.
Cotton.
Engineer. Engineer. Okay, one more. Okay, let's do it. To respect. Jun-gyong-hada. Okay, nice. That's it for the review. And now let's go into the lesson. Okay, 9 to 16, 14. So, yesterday we first of all learned about the state here, the part that was sadly muted and my streaming software crashed. Yeah, but we finished this one and then we learned about nada and nada. And yeah, just nada and nada. Not sure where exactly we stopped, but I think, yeah, this one I remember. I think here. I think we stopped here. Okay. So just to review, nada is for active verbs, nada for passive verbs, and the nada ones are pretty rare. And some nada verbs don't even have a nada verb. And it's pretty common to use a past tense. Not my homework is finished, but my homework was finished. Okay. Yeah, here again, nada is more common than nada in these cases. Homework was finished and not I finished my homework. Yeah, and then we have these things where you only have nada by itself with a noun before. Even if there's no space here, it's weird that there's no space here, in my opinion. Gyoknada. Here, for example, you see the space. So that's a bit weird to me. Here's also a space, and here's also a space. So there's a chance they maybe just forgot it. Let me translate this. Good thought, so good idea. And here we have an E. So this is subject particle. And here we have that thing as a subject. Yeah, it's definitely a different sentence here. For some verbs it's directly attached. Same with nouns with hada. Okay, I didn't know that. I thought if you separate hada from the noun, then you always need a particle, object particle, subject particle, whatever. But I mean, here this sentence is different anyways, because here you have the that is not in this sentence. Here you don't even have another noun. So here the sengak is the only noun in the sentence, but here you have another noun. You have this one and this one basically. So that's a different situation anyways. I think you can't separate all hada nouns. Yeah, okay. Yeah. Mm. Yeah, this little translation is definitely wrong as well. It's not my memory came up. There's clearly a that thing in this, and I know that you don't say it if you translate it, but the literal translation is that thing. The memory about that thing came up or whatever, but that's missing here. But yeah, okay, I will just remember Giok Nada as to remember. I think that's the easiest way to approach that. Okay, and now let's continue with where we stopped yesterday. Another common example of Nada is in use is the following phrase: Kun, which means big; Il, which means work or task; Nasoyo. And Nasoyo, before I continue to read, I will use the memorized translation again to have something that you didn't have before. So you have like a big task, a big work, a lot of work maybe, that you didn't have before. So you have to do a lot. Literally, this translates to a big thing came up. Yeah. I have a big task, big work. In Korean, this expression is similar to the expression "Oh no, something bad just happened." Okay. Oh crap. Yeah, okay, I can see that. Something bad happened, and we have a lot of like a big, it's a big work to fix that. A big work just came up by this bad thing happening. Okay, you will see nada used with many other words throughout Korean studies. The most common example of nada are the examples above. The other examples that you will learn shortly are provided below. I haven't included these verbs in vocabulary list above, so you don't need to memorize them now. I'm simply including them at this point, or introducing them at this point, because they are related to the topic. Okay, we learned suri. Sorry. Yeah, well, this one we basically learned as well. We learned Hwanada as one verb. So it was already obvious that this one is the noun being anger. But here they have it separated, Hwaganada and not Hwanada. Yeah, interesting. What else do we have? Accidents, Sago Ganada, or probably also Sagonada. Sweat to be sweating to for sweat to come up. Daminada. War. John. John Jeng. John Jeng. John Jeng. John Jeng. Okay. Motion sickness. Okay. Weird word. Molmi, Molmi, Molmiganada. Yeah, okay. Anyways, I mean, he said it. He didn't include them in the vocabulary list, so I'm really not learning them now, since they're not on the memorize course. So I really want to use memorize for my vocabulary learning. And if these are not in there, I will not learn them now. But I mean, like sound and anger we learned previously anyways. So these two are learned anyways. Okay. In a lot of these cases you will see nada conjugated into the past when we as English speakers would think of a situation in present tense. To explain this phenomenon, let me bring up an example from above. Ah, I remember that. Notice here, nada is conjugated to the past. Nada. But I have translated English sentence into present tense. Yeah. If I think about that, in German, I think both ways to use the present tense and the past tense are totally natural, and I think in English that's fine as well. If you say, ah, I remember that, that's fine, but in some situations, maybe not in all, but in some, you can also say, I remembered that, but yeah, okay, it's a different situation. We can't. Like if I think about something and I'm not remembering it, I'm thinking, and then now I remembered it. But that's another situation, so we cannot use that. That's only in this situation where you are thinking of something, but you can't quite remember it, and then that changes, and then you remembered it. Then it's natural to use past tense, in my opinion. But if you just say it without any story beforehand, then you would use present tense, I guess. Mm-hmm. Okay, but yeah, if you imagine your memory as a thing that can come up, then it had come up in the past, obviously, yeah. Here the context of the conversation can inform you if the speaker is referring to something in the past or present tense. Yeah. It is possible to use these words in present tense, but that would mean that the noun is currently coming up. I'm sweating. Dangi nasoyo. Sweat came up and now I'm sweating. Okay, so before I continue to read, if I would use this in present tense, so Danginayo. That means I'm beginning to sweat, right? Like I'm exercising or something, and I'm just beginning to start to like I'm starting to sweat. Let's see. Here again, you can see nada is conjugated to the past tense, but English sentence translated to the present tense. Just by nature of the word nada, to come out, when sweat has come out of your body, it means you now have sweat on your body, and in English would say I'm sweating. When nada is conjugated to the present tense in these cases, it insinuates, I don't know this word, that the thing is currently coming up. Yeah. I'm just starting to sweat, I think is a good example for that. Okay. However, let's split some hairs. Sweat was coming out of my body, which means currently sweat on my body, which means I'm wet from the sweat of my body, that I previously come out of my body. Jesus. Sweat is literally coming out of my body. Okay. Okay, yeah, the difference is clear. This whole path printing is quite advanced and not something I developed an understanding of until many years of exposure in Korean. As a beginners, you are still a beginners if you're only at lesson 14. Yes, I know, thank you. You probably don't need to worry about splitting these hairs. However, when I was learning, I would have wanted this to be explained to me at some point. So here I am explaining it to you. I should point out that we don't see the same phenomenon when these words are used in negative sentences. For example, if I say, the thing, giok, annasoyo, annaso. I'm not remembering that. The thought is not coming up. The memory is not coming up. Does the fact of your memory not coming up mean that it's currently not up when you said the sentence? Does the fact that your memory not coming up mean that it is currently not up when you said the sentence? Yes. Totally, yes. This type of past tense conjugated negative sentences with nada would only be used to say that you didn't remember something sometime in the past. If you want to say that you cannot currently remember something, you use a present tense conjugation. I didn't remember that at that time. I don't remember that. Yeah, okay. We just accept it. Okay, yeah, that was that chapter. This whole active passive thing is not easy. It's really not easy. One second. Okay. Okay, so far you've learned yeah, so next chapter, passive verbs, normal verbs. So far you've learned about dealing with hada, dweda, patta verbs. Verbs that can be in a state, and nada nada verbs. However, sometimes a verb that fits none of these conditions can be put into passive voice. All that needs to be done in these cases is to add a or jida to the verbs then to make it passive. Juda to give becomes juojida. Juojida. Oh yeah, note that the word is juojida and not juojida, which is basically the same pronunciation, right? Juojida. Juojida. Juo. Juo. Juojida. 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 Yeah, okay, you will have like a millisecond break in this. Juojida. And here it's more like draw, 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 draw dida. Okay, interesting. At least I think so. I mean, I have no confirmation for that assumption, but yeah, I will just think that it's that way. Jita to build. Giojida. Giojida. Yeah, why not Jisojida? This I don't understand. Why would you remove the S? Why is this true? Because it's an irregular, the S3 irregular. Quick check. Quick check, quick check. Lesson 7. Irregulars, S irregular. Just remove when adding a vowel. GG. Okay, we got it. I was hoping this would be a more logic chapter. Yeah, but this is actually the irregular. So this is fine. But the thing about the passive, present, about the sometimes you add a syllable but with other verbs you remove a syllable makes no sense. Yeah, that's it. Okay, that's it. I warned you earlier, there was a lot of grammar this lesson, though all this grammar is in this lesson is wow. So I'm a bit confused. Shouldn't this be although? For me it's weird that it's only though. Though all of the grammar in this lesson is very important and must be understood to continue your development of Korean, keep in mind that it's always more natural to use active sentences instead of passive sentences in Korean. Okay, so we can forget everything we just learned. Whew. Okay, that's the end of this lesson. And we have 20 minutes left. So, are we ready for the practice video? Or maybe, I think the practice videos are a bit more difficult compared to the exercises in the workbook. I think the exercises in the workbook are a good step in between, right? Let me open the exercise here. There we go. Where are we? Lesson 11, 12, 12, 13, lesson 14 here. Okay, so it's only this small one. Okay, let's do this one. I think this is a good thing to do at the end of the lesson, and then next time we will go into the practice videos. Okay. Here we go. Change the following active sentences into passive sentences. Yeah, the thing is, just changing it, just have the task to change the active into passive, that's not the harder part. That's the easiest part. The hard part is to know when you would actually use the active and when you would use the passive and in which tense, past tense or present tense, in a conversation. That's the hard part. Just transforming from active to passive, that's not the hard part. But anyways, we'll do it. Should be a good easy exercise to get ready for the videos. Okay, let's check sentence one first. 저는 문을 열어요. 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 Hmm? 저는 문을 열어요. 열어요. I open the door. 저는 문을 열어요. The door is open. It's in a state of being open. 문이 열려 열려 있어요. Wow, okay. So the passive is jolida, and then you add the oita. So this becomes not joli, but jolio, jolio, jolio. Isoyo. Okay, yeah, that's interesting. And that is for states that you add this oita. Okay, but now let's do the first, our first own sentence here. Sentence 2. 우리. Why is it not 우리 왜? Shouldn't be 우리 왜? Okay. Oh no, wait. 우리 already has this possessive included, right? Yeah, okay. 우리 어머니, 엄마, 우리 엄마는 음식을 요리해요. 요리해요. 우리 엄마는 음식을 요리요, 요리해요. 우리 엄마는 음식을 요리해요. Our mom food cooks. Okay. So now let's do it. The food is cooked. Is that a state? I think so. That's a state. Yeah, it's a state. It's a state. So we need food. Im Schick. We use the special subject particle, I or K. In this case, we use I. Im Schick I. And now we just put the. Wait, what? Oh, I thought it's just omitted because it's clear from the context. Nice to know it's already included. What are you talking about? Ah, about the Uri. Okay, if you're not sure on that. I'm not 100% sure myself, but I got introduced to the word Uri as we slash us. So that's why I think it's already included. But if you're not sure, let me check. Let me check here. Uri. So it can you mean we? Yeah, here you can see we, our, us, ours, ourselves. But if I put jaw, I, okay, here's also my, okay, so this doesn't confirm anything. I think I never saw Uriwe before. Yeah, it's interesting, right? Okay, one second. Uriwe. Okay, I have a website here. I just googled it. Hi Native, I was on this website a few times before. It's just a website where people can ask questions about the language, and then there are people from that language or that have that language as a mother tongue, so they are native in it, they answer. So here, what's the difference between Uriwe, Uri, and Nawe, Uriwe? We are here, I'm not sure. I hear both interchangeably to express my, even though Uri means our. Ah, okay, she's asking about this and this as a difference, and then this and this as a difference. And not these two as a difference. Okay, anyways, we will read the answer. Yeah, okay, this is not the question that we have. Okay, so this doesn't really help. Yeah, it is a thing, it looks like. You can say Uriwe, but I have not seen it before myself. Okay. Ja. What's the difference between Uri, Uriga and Uriwe? Okay, this is clear because this is just a subject particle. But this and this is the deciding part. We are our Urinin, Uriga. Yeah, okay, it doesn't really help, right? We a noun dictionary form. Subject marker. Possessive marker. Yeah, we know that already. But that doesn't really answer the question. Can this be, or is this even more natural also to use in a possessive variant? Yeah, okay. Well, yeah, go back. We'll go back to the exercise here. Yeah, not that important. I just think it's just very natural with Uri to omit it. While for the other ones, like Jaw, Na, it's not like you can use both, but in this case I think it's more natural to really not right way. That's what I think. Okay, so Imshigi is the food with the subject marker. And now we want to have is cooked. So the passive form of to cook is uri hada. So we have an hada verb, we can change it to dueda, right? Yuri dueda. Now we conjugate it to the same form that we have here, which is informal I respect. I think you can just say dueo. If I really conjugate this, if I really conjugate this, I would put dui and then oyo, right? And then I merge these together, but it's not possible because there are three vowels. Yeah. I think this form is fine. Okay, so but is this correct now? What about the tenses? Yuri, so I put the present tense now. Is that correct? I mean the English sentence is in present tense, but that doesn't have to mean anything. But I think for this state example, it's correct. Yeah, okay. I will leave it like that. Do you agree, Flo? Or do you think I forgot something or I made a mistake here? Okay, nice. Okay, then let's do the next one. Eggy? Oh, eggy, it means baby, okay. I have not learned this. Yeah, yesterday was a bit weird anyways because I did my vocabulary review and then I started with the grammar lesson and my streaming software crashed. And I didn't realize. I did like 5 minutes before I actually realized my streaming software has crashed. So that was unfortunate. Then I had like the stream of offline in that moment, and I did 5 minutes of the lesson. Then I realized I restarted my streaming software, turned it on again, and repeated those 5 minutes that I did, and like 5 more minutes. And then I realized I was muted the whole time because when I start my streaming software, I'm muted by default. So I did the first part of the grammar, the first 5 minutes, I did it twice and it was useless. And the second 5 minutes, I did it once and it was useless. So, yeah. So all these examples about the state where he really goes into detail for the 9 example sentences, that is missing. That material is basically unusable and lost. Yeah, but anyways, was unfortunate, but yeah, we will see. Okay, so Eginen, Eggy baby, okay. Eginen, Computore, Kojang, Nesoyo. Eginen, Computore, Kojang, Nesoyo. The computer was broken or is broken? Okay, so for this specific thing, I remember that the Kojang Nada is more common compared to Kojang Neda, but to break or yeah, to break is one of the few words where the Neda variant is also pretty acceptable. But yeah, nada is definitely the passive, Kojang nada. The question again is, which tense do we use? Yeah, we have to select what is more natural, I think. But let me do the beginning. Computer Computoga Computoga 거장나라. 거장났어요. 오케이. 거장. We have 나요 or 났어요. S. 나요 or 났어요. And for me, like from the lesson that we did, the lesson 14, I would 100% say 났어요. But I want to have a good explanation for that. I don't just want to say that because I feel like it should be the more natural thing. I want to have a good explanation. The baby broke the computer doesn't mean the computer is currently broken. That's true. Yeah, I'm definitely 100% with past form. I'm very confident in that. But let's say the computer is currently broken. I think you would still use the past tense. But why? Was broken. Let me find this one sentence here. Here, this one. This is the one. This highlighted sentence, that's the one I had in my mind. It is very common to use the past tense conjugation of both of these words in the passive voice, even when the thing is currently broken. Okay, so my feeling was correct. That's good. Okay, next one. I place the book on the table. 저는 탁자에 Ja, Johnin Takjae Checke No Hayo Noayo No Noayo Johnin Takjae Checke Noayo I On table, book, lay an object down. Okay. The book. Check. Checky. And these weird things. Cheggy is on the table. Ah, this was this weird for an object to be laying down, I think. This weird for translation. I'm not sure if I remember this. I don't think so. I don't think I remember. But is on the table. Was laid on the table. Was placed on the table. It's currently on the table. It's more like. I don't know, it's Takjae Yeah, I don't know, man. This is. Noida. Yeah, okay, that's it. Noida. Okay, yeah. I couldn't remember that anymore, sadly. Okay, No. Noida. Now conjugate. But to which tense? It's currently on the table. But it was placed on the table in the past. And being on the table is, I think, not a state. So I will say we use the past tense. So it becomes no noyosoyo, noyosoyo. I was first thinking about this ita state before you said there is an extra word for it. Yeah. But you still use this ita even if there's an extra word. You use this ita if it's a state. For example, the food is cooked. The computer's broken. Wait, shouldn't we use this here? Now that you mention it. No, because this one has an own word. It's a nada. A nada verb stays like it is here. The state word. Yeah, right. Okay, I got it. I got it. The state things where you add this ita, the ita, you only put it for the verbs that are not hada or nada. So for the verbs that only have da in the end after the stem. So what do we have here? We have noida, and that's one of those. But for me, this is not a state, so I will not use it. And it has its own word. Yeah, it's not a state, so I don't think we need this here. What about this one? This is the hada verb, so we also don't use it. Okay, so for me, it's fine like it is right now. Noyosoyo. Okay, now next one. I turn off the light. 저는 불을 꺼요. 저는 불을 넣어요. 꺼요. 저는 불을 꺼요. 저는 불을 꺼요. 꺼요. 꺼. 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 저는 불을 꺼요. Okay. 불이 Okay, and now it gets interesting, okay? Wait, you ask every time past for this one. Yeah, because the verb is to place something or to lay something down. And if something is on the table now, it was placed on the table in the past. If you're not currently placing it on the table, then it has to be past. That's why. Because here he did it a bit tricky. He used another verb to be instead of using the verb we have to use. And that's why you have a difference there in the present and the past. You look here, he uses place, he uses actual verbs that we want to change, but here he doesn't use it, so that's why the tense is different. But if you use the actual verb that we have here in this sentence as well, you would say the book was placed on the table and not is placed, no. No, it's the action of placing something. So I think this is correct. Okay, now we have light as the subject. It's turned off. Okay, so here we have an interesting situation. We have to turn off, which is it? Wait, Corda? It's. I think it's actually Gida as an active. So this one here, this conjugation on the left side, is actually Gida, but it's the Ö is removed because irregular, and then you have Oyo and it becomes Koyo. But if you actually have the passive, the stem itself is already Go. Gojida. I think Gojida. So now it becomes very interesting because now we have a verb that is not hada or nada neda. It's not that, it has its own word, but it is still a state. It's still a state. So in this case, in this case, we might want to use this itta, but now I must have remembering it wrong because the itta only makes sense for words where you can separate a noun, right? I'm not sure anymore. I'm not sure. I will read up that section. Where is it? This itta. Maybe just for words they don't have extra words. I'm not sure. Here. All those nouns are in the state of something. Here we have it. The is turned off. That's the sentence we have, right? We have the sentence, the light is turned off. And here we have an example sentence, the TV is off. So turned off. All those nouns are in the state. Computer in the state, blah blah. To indicate that's in the state, you must add. Okay, so I have the right thought. But how do we add this thing to Gojida? That's the question here. Here. Yeah, we just do it. We just do it. Okay, yeah. We simply just do it. No special things. We use the stem. We remove the da, obviously. We have the stem. And then we just simply add o. And then ita. We merge these together to build jo, and then we conjugate the ita in the end to isoyo. Okay, so yeah, I remembered that correctly. If we have a verb that is not hada or ne nada, and it is a state. Then we put this a or a itta or o itta. Only then. If it's not hada, if it's not nada or neda, and if it's a state. Then we put this itta. Okay. I finished the work. Jonin. Ihre Gynnesoyo. Gynnesoyo. The work was finished. Iri Iri Genada. Here we have a neda nada verb, so we don't put this ita. We just use the passive variant, which is nada. Yeah. And now we conjugate nayo. Next one. Dad locked the window. Aberginen. Changmunil. Jam gasoyo. Jam gasoyo. Okay. Aberginen. Changmunil. Jam gasoyo. The window was in the sea. Now he begins to actually help us. Okay. He's like, yeah, whatever, you have to think about for yourself what's if it's present or past tense. And now he's actually like providing the things we need to decide what we have to use. Okay, anyways, Changmuni. Was in the state of locked. Okay, the verb itself is jam geda. I think jam geda. How jam geda? We learned it has an extra word, but I'm not sure if I can remember that to be locked. Damn, I don't remember the extra word for it. Damn, I have to look it up. Ah, okay, you're putting it there. Okay, thank you. Jamgida. Okay, Jamgida. Okay, extra words. Okay, so here again, we can apply the logic. It is not a hada verb. It is not a ne or nada verb. And it's a state. In that case, we put this ita. So I remove the da. Now I put a ita or o ita. In this case, o ita. Now we merge this together. Gyota. Gyoita. Now we conjugate the ita by removing the da and putting oyo. Okay, easy. Yeah, so I think we are finished. Shall I check the answers, or is there anything left to discuss? Wait, what? Isasoyo. Ah, okay, you're talking about past tense. Yeah, that's a good point. The window was locked. Yeah, but this is really tricky what he's doing here. If it was locked, then it is locked now. So I would use present tense. But if you like remove this thing in brackets from sentence, it would read the window was locked. No, if you read what's in the bracket, the window was in the state of locked. That implies it's not locked anymore, maybe, or we have no information about that. But still, actually I'm not sure. Wait, what did we have here? No, here, sorry. The light is turned off. Okay, here we have present tense. I think present tense is correct. I don't get why 4 is not a state, but 5. 4. Yeah, why is this not a state? Yeah, the state of being on the table. Yeah, I don't know, man. That's the difficulty about this. Well, I can tell you why I decided like I did. So there was this whole explanation about the states, when it's a state and when it's not. But in the end, there was a statement like, yeah, don't worry about it. Mostly it's usually just the active form that is used. That's way more natural, blah, blah, blah. And the only, or pretty much the only most common words where you would actually use this state is to turn off, like turned off, turned on, open and closed. That's it. I can show you. Where's my browser now? There we go. Okay. So this whole state thing, where is it? Nedahada. Here. Yeah, that was exactly the thing that I did yesterday that was kinda lost. But it's hard. I still don't fully understand it. The door was closed. The door was closed by the wind. We didn't know how the door was closed. Blah blah. I closed the door. The door was closed. The door closes. Here we have the past form that you mentioned. Was closed. This is another past tense. Notice the difference in sentence and the two examples above. Here, the sentence is specifically indicating the door was in the state of closed. We have absolutely no idea if somebody had opened it recently, or we know that at that time the door was not open. So, okay, we use the past tense when you want to say it was in that state in the past, and we have no information about what state it is now in. So, what do we have here is on the table. Yeah, that's definitely not past because it's now on the table. But what about the last part? The window was locked. To be honest, I think it's just an unfortunate wording here. Because he put this in the state of here. If you read this in state of, it was in state of locked. I don't think that's what he actually means. I don't think he wants to say the window was in the state of being locked. I think he wants to say the window was locked, and then he just put this in the state of as a little helper in there, but he didn't intend that part to be really part of the sentence. I think the sentence is reading, the window was locked and it is now in the state of being locked. And since that's, yeah, and if that's true, we will not use the passive because it's currently now in the state of locked. It was locked in the past and is now in the state of locked. We don't want to specifically indicate that, yeah, back then when this crime happened, I remember in that moment it was closed. It was in the state of closed in that specific moment in the past. That's not what we want to say here. I think we really just want to say it's locked now. It was locked, and now it is locked. Yeah, so that's my take on that. But I still wanted to show you this last part. Here, this part here. Just because an active verb has a passive equivalent doesn't mean you can attach this to it, this indicating the state, to describe that it's in the state of something. Typically, this is only done for words like on, off, open, closed. And here we have like a counter example, so that something else is not a state. So here, I tricked my friend, active sentence, I was tricked by my friend, but I'm in the state of being tricked. You could argue that can happen, that can be true, but he's saying this doesn't make sense. Once you're tricked, you do not continue being in the state of tricked, like a door continues to be open. Okay, but the book is still on the table, right? So yeah, this logic doesn't really apply. Let's check the answers. Oh my god, it's it's already half past seven already. Jesus, time flies. Okay, so I have the answer here. Wait, this is not the answer. One moment. Exercise 15. I don't understand the English 7. That the window is closed now, but it's just, yeah. Yeah, let's see. I think this in the state of is not intended to be part of the sentence. It's just a little helper. He should put it in brackets after the sentence, in my opinion. But we'll see. Okay, I have the answers now. I put it on the screen. Okay, so here are the answers. These are the answers. Exercise 15. And we will now check what I wrote first. We skip the first sentence because that's already pre-written. So this is the first sentence we wrote. Imshigi yori doeyo. Let's see. Sentence number two. Imshigi duri doeyo. Correct. Next one. Number three, I wrote computer ga kojang nasoyo. Kojang nasoyo. Number three, computer ga kojang nasoyo. Perfect. Okay, now we will get to the interesting part. Sentence number four. I wrote checky tak jae no yosoyo 노였어요. 노였어요. Number four. 책이 탁자에 놓여 있어요. Okay, it is the state variant. So being on the table is a state. Okay. So we have here we have the 여 있어요. Yeah, okay. So we will fix that here. We have 여 있어요. Okay, so this is a state. So the example that we had in the grammar lesson with being tricked, you are tricked, but you don't continue to be in the state of being tricked. But the book, when it's placed on the table, will continue to be on the table. So if we apply that logic, then it makes sense. It fits. So this is a state. If something continues to be in that result of the action, then it's a state. Okay. Yeah, that's my understanding for now. Let's see. Okay, number five. Puri ko jossisoyo. Go jo isoyo. Wow. This seems wrong. Okay, number five. Ko jo isoyo. It's correct. Go jo isoyo. Go jo, just the space. I forgot the space. Okay. Yeah, okay, this is correct. 100% sure Korean natives would have mistakes in this exercise. Yeah, you know what? This would be a good idea to let the Korean native do this. I have some connections because of StarCraft to some Koreans. And some Koreans already spoke to me and told me, yeah, if I have any questions, I can ask them and so on. Like Cast the Muse, you saw him here in the stream sometimes as well. But I still want to have way bigger knowledge of Korean and be able to talk to a Korean in a half solid conversation. But then if I'm at that state of being fluent in Korean, like half fluent at least, then I will actually do that. Then I will put the exercises to the native Korean and ask them to do that. I am poor, aber am Wochenende machst du doch Brood War. Meaning, but on the weekend you're streaming Brood War. Yes, that's a correct statement, I am poor. That's a correct statement, but not every single day of the weekend. I did stream for 5 hours yesterday, and I will stream tomorrow again. So Friday and Sunday I will always stream Brood War. Today on Saturday I will not. No. Okay. Yeah, let them do this exercise. Yeah, I will. Okay, but let's continue now. Number six. So I wrote Iri Gunnayo. Gunnayo. Okay, Gunnayo. Iri Gunnayo. And it is Gunnaso. Ah, yeah, wow. Gunnasoyo, obviously. I mean, I said it earlier. I said it earlier with these Na, nada, things you. It's super way more common to put it into the past tense. I explained it to you, Flo, when we had this sentence. I said it. I even showed you the sentence on the lesson, but here I forgot it again. So obviously it's nasoyo. Well, this overtime again today. This lesson is too hard for 1 hour. Yeah, we have a lot of overtime lately. Yeah, but it's fine. Okay, last sentence. Chongmuni Chomgyo Isoyo. Chomgyo Isoyo. Okay, let's see if it's past tense or present tense. It is past tense. Okay. Yeah, but it's really, I think it's interpretation. I think it's just, it depends on if you read this. I can't. If you read this in the state of flocked, if you have this as part of the real translation or not. If you say the window was in the state of locked, then it's like you're describing, yeah, back then on last Friday at 6 o'clock, it was closed. Then it's really talking about a state in the past. But if you don't use these brackets, if you just say the window was locked, then you're talking about the action. It was locked and is now in the state of locked currently as a result of that. Yeah, okay. So we have Isosoyo. Okay, the rest was correct, right? Jamgyo, yeah. Jamgyo. Jamgyo? Jamgyo, Yeah, Jamgyo is correct. Okay. So, that's it for today. What have we learned? We add o ita or a ita when it's a state. We add that. If it's a state, ita to the stem. What we learned as well, nada. Nada verbs are almost always in the past tense. We also learned this state thing and this ita is not happening for words with hada or nada. It's only for words, yeah, that are not hada or nada, neda. And that's it. Okay, if we really learned everything correctly, we'll find out next time on the practice videos or in the practice videos. That will be interesting, especially the listening video. So we'll do the two practice videos tomorrow. We'll see how long we need for the first one. But yeah, that's happening tomorrow. And for today, I say thank you for participating and watching. And see you tomorrow. Bye bye. Annyeong.